Weaves are more secure. Wigs could get snatched.
I'm bullheaded under here.
But
I don't ever wear bonnet outside.
It's me with the Nekalon here, and then my natural hair is braided into that.
I have a blue one. I have an orange one.
Daniels.
What?
Daniels.
Pantyhose?
It's not.
Stockings?
I have two blonde ones. So I have a long blonde and I have a short blonde. I wouldn't be mad, like, unless you trying to, like, mess up what's going on. I have a short curly. That's five. So, like, I bought a straight wig that kind of looks like my hair. I have this one. That's six.
Yes, I let guys touch my hair, even during stuff.
A burgundy. Burgundy bang and bob.
At night, I use a satin bonnet to protect my hair.
That is seven.
So more than 10?
I'm gonna say around 10. I don't wanna say more than, you know, it could be 9. It could be 9.
Wearing her hair in the afro, 1971, is it Oprah? Was that right?
No, let me get the choices first.
Well, I just got these done, whatever.
I never had to do it. Actually, now, matter of fact, I did buy some shit before.
You a sucker.
Nah, it was my girl though. It was my girl.
You gotta make that clear. You gotta make that clear.
Nah, bro, it's my girl, bro.
The kitchen, your neck back. Back here.
Who was fired from her job at ABC Affiliate for wearing her hair in an afro in 1971? Angela Davis, Melville Tolliver, Marsha Hunt, Diana Ross.
Repeat that again.
Who was fired from their job for wearing their afro?
Repeat that.
Oh my goodness, I know her face.
I don't even remember the choices.
Angela Davis. See, I don't even know who that is.
Is it Diana?
Diana Ross.
See.
I'm gonna say Marsha Hunt.
Wearing her hair in the afro, 1971. Is it Oprah? Was that right?
D.
Tyler.
Where did wigs first become a way to denote social status, wealth, and even religious piety?
Say the question one more time.
Where did wigs first become a way to denote social status, wealth, and even religious piety? England, Africa, Egypt, or Israel?
England.
Go with Africa.
India?
Indian?
Yeah. England?
I'm thinking that hard. Like, I feel like I'm more, are you smarter than a fifth grader?
England.
England.
Egypt.
Egypt. Christina Jenkins invented the hair weaving process when? 1951, 1926, 1964, 1972.
The what process?
Weaves were created in 1961.
I don't know.
1964.
I'm gonna get them all wrong. So
1972.
What was the second option?
1951. Yeah. Ah, look at me getting something. I knew that.
1951. I was gonna say that.
51.
1961.
1951.
Oh, that's the one I meant. Okay. 2017.
Mark Jacobs was accused for cultural appropriation. Mostly white models
walk
around wearing what? Dreadlocks, box braids,
bantu
knots, or
bow
twists?
Dreadlocks. Got one.
Win.
All right, so boom, so the girl came to me talking crazy. I popped on her wow.
What type of hair do you have right now?
I have natural hair, but I do wear some form of extensions to accentuate the volume of it.
I have on a wig. It's Malaysian virgin hair,
natural.
Well, these are my box braids. It's made with Kanaka Lawn hair, and then my natural hair is braided into that.
So this is my Indian body weight hair. And it's about 22 inches. And yeah, it's a closure wig unit.
This is me, natural hair, box braids, Fulani braids.
Braids, box braids, I have box braids.
I have natural healthy hair.
I have in braids.
This is my natural hair, natural curls. It's in a wash and go. This is my natural hair texture.
This is body wave, 22 inches.
I have on a nice closure wig right now, as you can see. This is mink Brazilian hair. Mink Brazilian hair is like the better type of Brazilian hair. It's sturdier, it's silkier, shinier, all types of stuff. The best type.
What is good hair?
Good hair is healthy hair, like that. It has to be natural. It has to have good texture, and yeah.
Good hair, honestly, good hair is any hair. As long as the hair makes you feel confident, I feel like good hair will be characterized as anything from wigs to natural hair to weaves to anything.
I think good hair to me, it could be anything. As long as you're confident in the hair that you have on your head, that's good hair.
I would say good hair is healthy hair. If your hair is taken care of, if your hair is however you like to have your hair, I think it's good hair.
Would you ever let a white woman do your hair?
Would I have a little white woman do my hair? Depending, no. I have to think about it. I was like, no.
I would not let a white woman do my hair because I don't feel like most white women have the capability to do hair that they don't have themselves.
No. I wouldn't let a white woman do my hair because I feel like she wouldn't know what she's doing.
There's no room for something so intrinsic to my culture, to my community, for someone else to be adopting, appropriating, or learning about beyond the context of like the white women who have black children. But would I ever let a white woman do my hair? No.
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 No, I would not let a white woman do my hair because I just feel like it just would not turn out well. In terms of even just caring for my hair, period, during the process of trying to do my hair, it's just not gonna turn out well.
When your hair isn't did, how do you feel? Sad, depressed?
When my hair's not done, I guess I feel incomplete. Like, I feel like my hair is a big part of me.
When my hair is not done, I feel ugly. No, honestly, the one thing I know about hair, and I feel like everyone can vouch for it, is like, if your hair is not done, it messes up your whole look. Like, your hair brings up your look in most cases. So if it's not done, it's over.
I don't know, I don't feel as cute, but I also feel like there are things that you can do. Definitely. I feel like your hair kind of, it is you in a sense. So like, I feel like if your hair is done and you still look a mess, you don't look a mess because your hair is done.
Have you ever been judged for your hair?
Probably, but I'm not sure. Like, I don't have a specific instance, but I'm pretty sure I have.
A lot of times. I change my hair like almost every week.
Judged all the time. I'm always judged for my hair. I wear it like this.
I'd say I've been judged for my hair.
How long does it take to do your hair?
For this style, I would say it takes maybe an hour fully. So to wash it, detangle it, condition it, wash it, detangle it, condition it, and then I have to put all the products in. And then depending on if I air dry or blow dry, it could take different times. If I want to air dry it, it's like all day. If I want to blow dry it, maybe like 30 minutes extra.
If it's a closure wig, it'll probably take me less than 5 minutes, depending on what I'm trying to do. But if I'm just wearing it as how it is, a minute.
To do my hair, it could take days, honestly. I've been up maybe, if I finish my hair straight, I've been up for 12 hours straight doing my hair.
Well, to do these box braids, it took me about like 2 days, simply because they're very long and I get lazy doing my own hair. But say I was doing someone else's hair in this style, it would take like maybe 9 hours.
How much money do you spend in your hair?
How much? I think in a month, I'm not gonna hold you, I probably spend like $200 on my hair.
A lot.
Well, I just wear wigs now, so it could vary from 500 to 600 to 1,000. It depends.
I say I spend about maybe $50 to $100 a month on my hair.
Weekly, monthly, yearly?
Monthly.
I spend about maybe $300 on my hair every month.
What age did you put
relaxing? At the age of 5, I had my first relaxer.
Too early. I permed my hair when I was about 6 years old. I know, so early. I was speeding. I was telling my mother, I was like, I want to have the straight hair. I want to go get a blowout at the Dominicans. And I messed up my hair because my hair was beautiful.
I was in the 7th grade, so like... 7th grade.
I actually didn't put relaxer. I never had a relaxer, actually. I've always straightened.
How do you protect your hair at night?
Actually, for the most part, like 80% of the time, I don't protect my hair.
I wear a bonnet. I make sure I oil it every 2 nights, every 3 nights, because you want your hair to make sure it's, you want to make sure your hair is moisturized, especially with 4C hair. You want to make sure under your wigs, your braids are moisturized, and you're protecting it with like a satin bonnet.
I wear a bonnet.
A bonnet.
Do you let guys touch your hair?
If I let guys touch my hair? If they ask, I mean, guys don't really ask to touch my hair though, so it's just like, but. I mean, really, no one should be putting their hand in my hair, period.
No.
I don't really let guys touch my hair. Guys feel like they can.
Do I let guys touch my hair? No. Not really. I don't really let guys touch my hair.
I don't like anyone touching my hair.
What about
my sex? Yeah, go ahead. You can touch it, you can feel it, you can pull it if you want. Go ahead, have fun.
But it depends. It depends what wig I have on. Like, it depends on what wig I'm wearing that day.
Maybe. Depends.
I don't think I have the power to stop someone from touching my hair during sex, so.
Okay. Yes. Yes, I you got me.
That changed quickly.
Yeah, that did change quickly. I would say yes. I like my hair to be like plaited in, pulled a little bit.
Yes, I do.
When I'm having sex, he's not pulling my hair, but like he's not yanking it. We're not doing all that. But I wouldn't be mad, like unless you trying to like mess up what's going on, I'm fine.
I can't have sex with a fresh dude. That's number one, my hair.
If you just got your hair laid, it's not gonna be laid when you're done.
Like a wig? Like, either I'm gonna have to take that off. I'm so serious. Unless it's like a frontal or something, I'm about to tie it up, fix it up, because I'm not gonna mess up my hair.
You feel like that girl. You feel like that girl. You got your new hairdo, and you know.
Yes, I let guys touch my hair. Even during stuff.
Yes, I do have a haircut. My hair business is called Wigs by Danica, and I've been doing this for about 2 years now.
So Wig Life is a custom unit business. We specialize in, you know, making custom wigs made specially to a person's head size, the textures they want, the lengths that they want, all of that to get their desired look. So we definitely do that to like, you know, boost people's confidence and things like that.
Jada did my hair. I do braids, mostly natural styles for women and men, but mainly women, just to enhance their beauty.
I have an online business where if you have a product, you can hire me to present those products on social media.
My hair business is named Hairaspora. It's basically just a conjunction of hair and of the diaspora. I created it in about 2016, but the name was generated about last year, and I really just wanted to do it with the intent of doing affordable hair for college students and making sure that we were like depicted in the ways that make us happiest, like when our hair is looking nice, when we feel like we're looking nice, and also like the journeys that we go on with that.
We cater to everything that has to do with beauty, wigs, sew-ins, makeup, one-stop shop.
The first time I got braids, the pain was like crazy. Like, I really wasn't used to it, but also I've mostly done my own braids for forever. So the pain is kind of nothing to me now. This is our culture. This is something that we emulate and that we embody. So white women just really have no space in that. Actually, growing up, I didn't get my hair braided. My mom, she's an immigrant. She's from Guyana, and like, she has very curly hair, so she really never had to do anything with it, but like, put water in it. So I didn't get my hair braided growing up until I was like 16. I used to ask my friend to give me like two cornrow braids. And one day she was just like, "You need to learn how to braid." So I learned how to braid, and I was terrible for like 2 straight months during the summer. And then suddenly I could braid. I typically keep my braids in for like a month, but I'm trying to change that because I just have a problem with that. Like, I like switching my hair up. I think if any black men don't like braids, it's probably has something to do with the fact that they have a lack of comfort with black women, which means they have a lack of comfort with their own sense of self. Doing your hair and learning more about your hair is a journey, like everything else.
My braids have never really been too tight, but they're usually not too tight. Cultural appropriation with hair is a confusing topic. Cultural appropriation in general, getting my hair braided growing up, I feel like as a kid, you're mad tender-headed, like always. Like, it's always a big deal, but it's really not that serious. I typically keep my braids in max 4 weeks. I feel like men don't like braids because they're one of those styles that can be in for a long time, and they probably get like a little like grossed out by that.
Braids are too tight. I try to sleep it off, honestly. I haven't had many experiences like that, but when I did, I just like tried to sleep it off. And so when white women wear like box braids, faux locks, there was a time when I didn't have a problem with it, but then I started to think about it like, one, their hair cannot really get into that style and stay and look proper. So it's like, why are you doing that to yourself? Two, that's not your culture. And it's like, a lot of the women who do it, it's like ignorance behind it. Like, they don't know origins of it, anything like that. So kind of mixed feelings, because I do believe everyone can do what they want, but it's like, just save that for us. That's ours. Growing up, my mom would pull my hair. It would be painful, but I'm not tender-headed. So it kind of worked for me when I was younger, getting my hair done. At a certain age, I started getting my hair straightened, though, which made it sort of more manageable and less pain, like when my mom did it. I typically want to keep it in. Well, I typically want to keep braids in for about a month, but sometimes, like being in school, I go like 6 weeks. So it varies, but I try to do maybe 4 to 6 weeks because then you have to wash your hair, it gets dirty, itchy, and I'd be over it. I never understood why men didn't like box braids. I don't understand that whole thing that's going around now. I don't know. I feel like men are, well, of course not all men, but I feel like men have gotten used to women wearing wigs, wearing weaves, and it looks nice. Like, don't get me wrong, I love a good frontal, but I feel like men have gotten used to that look, that straight, that sleek look.
Because I don't, like, honestly, I don't like people touching my hair. Like, if it's not me doing my hair, my mother. So, like, this time I was like, all right, fuck it, I'm getting older, why not? I feel like, honestly, there's just so many things that we could do with hair. I don't feel like they need, like, they should feel the need to do box braids. I feel like that should just be left to us. I think I'm going to keep these in for, like, 3 weeks, a month, possibly. I don't think it's that men don't like braids. I think that there's just a stigma behind braids. I think it also comes with the person's hair texture with the braids too.
Weaves are more secure. Wigs could get snatched. Like you question about sex, I'm not trying to have my wig come off. So I have clip-ins in my hair. Tap it when it get itchy, you know? Like, the kitchen is the back of your head. I got the kitchen going on right now. The BDBs. closure all day. If I'm wearing a, if I'm doing it, I'm gonna do it all. If you're gonna do a weave, you have to do at least 3 bundles. You're gonna have me looking bald.
The back is weave, then the top is pony. This pony is weave, but this little section right here, that's all me. This is, I believe, Brazilian, 22 inches. The kitchen, your neck back here. The little beady beads in the back. Keep my weave in for a month if it's done correctly. I usually use 3 bundles in my hair. I'd rather wear a weave than a wig because it's more natural sometimes. Not everyone knows how to lay a wig or do a wig. If it's my hair that's out, I can like finesse it and fix it.
I do feel ghetto when I wear a bonnet outside. I don't ever wear a bonnet outside. I add heat to my hair, but like I haven't done it in a while. My favorite natural hair product is gel. Yeah. Yes. If I'm washing my hair, just shampoo, conditioner, depending on what I'm doing to my hair, like the style that I'm going for, if I'm going for a wash and go, then gel. And then dry it and then go to sleep, twist out some twisting cream, twist it up, go to sleep, let it out in the morning. I've never done a big job. I just don't like having short hair, so I've had long hair my whole life, so I just let the permed hair grow out. I don't think I've ever dread my hair. No, I don't really like dreads for myself, personally. I don't know, I just feel like they wouldn't look right on me.
So to typically do my hair like this, I would start by detangling, shampooing, deep conditioning, and then styling. To style, I'll use a leave-in and then gel. I'll let it dry overnight. Yeah. People always ask me if I'm mixed. I straighten my hair. I haven't straightened it in maybe 4 or 5 years. My favorite natural hair product is Shea Moisture's Honey and Manuka Deep Condition. I would never dread my hair. I like my curls too much, too fun.
I add heat to my hair occasionally, but not too much because the last time I added heat to my hair, I got heat damage, probably a few months ago. So I don't wanna do that anymore. I'd rather just put a wig on. So like I bought a straight wig that kind of looks like my hair so that I won't have to put heat on my own hair. Like my father, he always told me growing up, like don't put a bonnet on your hair. So I feel like I can't. I don't even want to go outside because I feel like my father instilled it to me, don't wear a bonnet or a scarf outside the house. My favorite natural hair product is, I would say, Shea Moisture Curl Enhancing Smoothie. Either I co-wash or use a regular shampoo. I deep condition, detangle, and then I just put product in my hair. I put a cream and a gel. Rake it through my hair, smooth it through my hair, and then let it air dry. I have not done the big chop. So I've always been natural, but I used to straighten my hair all the time, so I had heat damage. So I didn't have to do a big chop to get my natural curls back. I just had to deep condition it a lot. So I didn't have to, I just had to cut the ends of it that were really, really damaged, but I didn't have to do a big chop. Sometimes people think I'm coolie, I guess, mixed with a little bit of Indian-ish. Sometimes people think I'm Dominican, but I'm just none of that. I don't know, my mom, actually my half of my family has dreads. My mom, my father, my brother, my aunts, they all have dreads. But I think it's too permanent of a decision for me. I think I like to switch my hair up a lot. So I like to do faux locks. So I've done that a bunch of times and I think it fits me, but I wouldn't want to have that all the time.
How many wigs do I have collectively right now? You could say 8. Do I prefer my wigs to be glued down or glueless? Both. It just depends on the event, the time, where. What do I have underneath my rig right now? A wig cap and my bowl head. I'm bald-headed under here. How do I protect my hair at night? I'm bald-headed under here, so I just sleep however. Because I feel okay with myself, so, but I'm just not going to take off my wig. I started doing wigs to give people a protective style for their hair to be protected.
I have a blue one. I have an orange one. I have I have two blonde ones. So I have a long blonde and I have a short blonde. I have a short, short curly. That's five. I have this one. That's six. I have a burgundy. Burgundy bang and bob. So that is seven. I started wigs because there was a demand for it. People need, because you know when your hair is done, your confidence is on 100. So people need to be able to feel confident, self-esteem needs to be able to be up. I have straight bags, glueless baby. Because since I joined the wig life, I don't like having like hair on my head, especially if it's like, and by hair on my head, I mean like, you know, like these, like a bunch of bundles on my head, like especially when I'm sleeping, like it's just unnecessary. If you can be free, be free. So I like being able to take it off at night.
So you see, only a select few people get that, like that privilege to FaceTime me without my hair on. If I don't know you like that, only a select few people. You do not get to see my meeks unless like we're on a different type of level. I prefer glueless because I don't like the whole idea of like always gluing it and like keeping it like keeping up with it. But and I like to keep my hair off. I like to take my hair off at night. But gluing it down definitely gives it the more refined look and it keeps it nice. I don't wear any caps usually unless I have a frontal. And yeah, just like cornrows, straight backs, the regular old straight backs, you know. Don't ask me to see them. Why? Why would you? Goodbye. Next. You see, I'm a teacher and my kids try to play me and I'm like, relax, my wig is always secure. That's one thing, if you're wearing a wig, make sure it's secure. Whether it's clips, glue, spray, whatever. So I started doing wigs because I finally decided to go natural while I was in college. And I started doing like closure sew-ins and I was going away and I told my hairdresser like, I want to get a wig, how much would that cost? And she said $300 without the hair included. And I was like, what? And I was like, that's a dub. So I was like, you know, YouTube is about to be my best friend and I'm going to figure out how to do it myself. And ever since then, I started doing wigs and people liked them and they became interested and I started selling.
Nobody's lying.
Have you ever paid for a girl to get
her
hair
done?
Never.
Wait, to get her hair done?
Yeah, I have. Not that, have I not. Have. I ain't gonna lie.
I actually, now, matter of fact, I did buy some shit. Man,
you a sucker.
That was my girl, though. It was my girlfriend.
You gotta make that clear. You gotta make that clear.
Nah, bro, it's my girlfriend.
Bro, you. Oh, you say your girl. Bro, still, bro. I've never
what you mean? You think I'm talking about a Trish, bro? Ain't no Trish shit, man.
Why don't you like braids on girls?
Who said that? I love girls with braids. You wildin'.
Nah, those meeks is a dog.
Oh, we talking about like meek braids.
Yeah, those are dog.
You talking, what kind of braids you talking?
I feel like some girls be looking valid with it. Honestly, it depends though. Like, for me, it's just like every hairstyle. Like, sometimes it's valid, sometimes it's not. I don't know. It just, feel me?
That's
it,
a fact.
Just,
that's a fact.
It depends on your face.
The braids is cool. Yeah. I like it better than wigs. I'm not even gonna lie to you.
You feel girls with natural hair or wigs?
It depends, first off. If you got some hair, then yeah. If you don't got no hair, you better throw that wig on.
It's like, if your wigs are laid, like, I'm not gonna hate on you and be like, yeah, okay, boo.
Don't have one for every day of the week.
Natural hair, for sure.
Yeah, I would jack natural hair.
The curls, bro, what? Bro, come on now.
Nah, I'm not gonna lie, like, some shorties that be doing the big chop, like, after they, like, he damaged their hair and shit, that shit come back fire.
Suck.
Come on, I don't think I gotta answer that if I just answer natural.
I mean, I would prefer natural, you feel me? But like, if you have like some laid wigs, you feel me? Like, I can't even tell, like, I won't mind.
You get a girl with a boy cut, she got the same ball as you.
Nah. Gotta go.
Okay.
Super.
It depends on the girl.
It depends. Some shorties
throw out that. That situation just sounds unfathomable.
Nah, some girls can really rock the ball cut.
As in like, shit like this, like a fade like this?
I mean, if her ass kind of fat, I'd be looking valid with the bowl cut, but like other girls,
nah,
be looking
bald, like. I can't do bowl.
So what, you want the, like, the auntie cut?
Yeah, you got
her,
yeah,
little auntie cut.
Yeah, Emma,
right.
Like Emma,
bro,
she not bald.
Nah, my barber line be yeah, official. I mean, her shit can't be better than mine. No way.
She fire.
Bro, if her hairline is better than your shit, it's a problem.
Hold on, what's going on?
You know what that is?
Pantyhose.
What?
Pantyhose.
Pantyhose?
It's not.
Stockings?
It's a stocking cap. Facts. It's a stocking cap or a pantyhose that you cut up? Which one?
Stocking cap?
Yeah, this is a stocking cap joint for the waves. Yeah, you know
how this goes. You feel me? You can't use this on your waves.
Well, you know about this. Yes, it is.
You cut up. Put it on my head?
I only use straight silkies.
Everybody know about this. You gotta throw on this joint.
I feel like this be messing up my waves.
Nah.
He putting a stocking cap on his head. Like, you about to go throw somebody's face on.
Like that?
Say that.
Give me the green one. You better give me the green one because I got
say
green
that.
One. I got green one. Nah, y'all tweaking right now.
Oh, yeah.
I look like I had a long night. I'm not jacking it.
Yo, y'all tweak, bro. Nah.
Come on. I don't do bangs, bro. Which way I'll put this?
There's a group that
come
to your mom. We got
the big
one.
Listen.
Oh, this gave me trees,
yeah, vibes. I need to get this shit out of here. I was a shorty, like, seeing me right now. I mean, I would be like, sis, where you got your wig from? Like,
nah. Hold on, if you want to talk about that, first of all, the drip besides this.
Oh, no, I'll be like, yo, bro.
You did that
this
on purpose.
This is some slime.
Yeah, like you like, did that on purpose.
Big slime.
I see the green.
Yes. Yeah, like.
Big trees. Wow, you really look like one of them, bro.
Yo, bro, you violent, bro. Feel like a rock star.
Can you tell us so we?
I'm hot, bro. What?
You said tell her what?
How y'all wear this?
Thank you, bro. This bang gotta go.
Nah.
Kind of. Cause it depends. Cause some shorties, bro, they don't like this little thing in the middle. Like they some shorties, like you could see it.
How much it costs? That's how much I hate.
What do I love about it? I mean, I don't know. I mean, I think it's all beautiful. All types of hair is beautiful to me. I mean, if it makes you feel good, then rock that shit. As long as you're not out here looking crazy. Hey?
Slow, first of all.
I hear it. Can be sticky. I felt that.
That happened too much.
Nah, but like, I also love that.
I love when your hair smells good.
Nah, yeah, I also love that.
What is a co-op?
Co-wash. I heard co-wash? Of a wash and go. I don't know what no co-wash is. What
a co-wash. Like wash.
Co-wash
your hair with somebody else.
I have no idea. I don't co-wash. I don't know.
Like a co-wash? Like
what?
I'm going to say like
how?
Like another girl like washing another girl hair. So.
Nah, that's chop.
That's chop.
That's chop.
What is pre-poo?
Pre-pool? Yeah, I don't got the answer
pre-pool
for that.
Pre-pool?
Nah, I don't got no answer for that. No.
You gotta shampoo before you shampoo.
I know stuff like deep conditioning. That's it.
I don't know what pre-pool is, bro. Is that even a real word, bro?
Pre-pool?
Pre-pool? That's not a real word.
What is a foursuit?
Is that a bro size?
Real like kinky nappy hair, like to the point where like shorty can't even like use a comb type, like it's gonna break.
Well, see, that's a hair type.
I know
4X. Sound like freaking, I don't know, 4C.
Sound like an apartment. You know, not a building.
Not the building. Sound like the house or the place. You know what I'm saying? The building.
It's the room, really.
Yeah, the room. Facts.
Room
4C. Yes, room 4C.
Hi.
Yo, I'm filming you right now, alright?
Wait, what?
You're right screen recorded. Yeah,
like,
right now.
Right now?
Like right now.
What's wrong with you?
It's for my documentary.
Why
get
you
up.
Said this earlier?
Put on a wig or some shit. You look crazy.
Now I have to go put on a wig.
Facts. Alright, hurry up. 1, 2. That's 2 seconds.
How you gonna scream for me and not give me a heads up?
Yeah, I gave you a heads up 2 seconds ago.
I'm
I see
ready
you.
For my close up.
Alright.
Is that Heman?
What's good, Ashley?
Hey,
you really be dragging it.
Like right now. Movie.
Like right now.
Right
my
now.
Hair. He's I didn't even right do now. My lashes.
Oh my god.
Nah.
It's fine. It's cool. Still a
bad bitch.
Who cares? Still
listen,
a bad
yo.
Bitch. Period. Period. But what Drake said, bro?
What Drake said?
More films?
More films
for
your head top?
So watch how you speak on my name, you know?
And more tune for your head top. So watch how you speak on my name, you know?
It's a damn.
Yeah.
With
the big can't do like me. Baddest girl to arrive on the scene. I'm a shake, I'ma kill this beat. Two kicks a slap, cause the girl elite. Every day of the week, of the week. Stay fly and the fist stay clean. Why the girl tryna hate on me? Meanwhile the man tryna grip this weave. Take a trip to Dubai and LA. Then I dip your arm out to the A. Night job to the next Monday. Back to the chips on New York I lay. What they can't do like we, what they can't do like me. Yeah, they can't do it like we, what they can't do it like me. Yeah, they can't do it like we, what they can't do it like me. Yeah, they can't do it like we, what they can't do it like me. Close enough, one shot, two shot, that's mad huff. Who's hot, who's not, call that bluff. I get the coins, I'ma strut my stuff. Hey, yeah man, damn fam, why your man's ran? Said he was about it with the blam blam. My niggas pull up and we jam, damn. Yeah, posted up,
got okay, where's that?